You guys, this blaster right here is everything. I mean, if you have your DZP Mark II, let's talk about this thing because wow. And if not, what are you waiting for? You definitely want to watch this video because you're going to love this thing. Let's check it out. What is up, Nerf Nation? I'm Naptown Nerf, and this is obviously an unboxing and review of the Dart Zone Pro Mark II. In my opinion, the best Nerf pistol ever made. And that includes any community-made pistol, any third-party market pistol, anything. This is the best sidearm I've ever used. And I cannot wait to talk to you guys about it. Man, Dart Zone, you guys just keep knocking it out of the park. And this is something that I've been looking for a long time. Something that packs a punch in a very small package and holds multiple darts in an internal magazine. So let's check this baby out, guys. Went ahead and removed the front attachment piece, which is this guy right here. This is just for cosmetics, and I actually really love this part. This just slides right on the bottom of the faux Picatinny rail, by the way. This is not actual Picatinny, so you will not be able to put any sort of attachments, to my knowledge anyways, on here. It doesn't seem to be quite the same size, at least the things I've tried won't work. But this just slides right on here and makes the blaster look really, really cool. And this is how I will be running it if I decide to run this as like a primary in a round, because honestly, it just looks awesome and it just makes me feel much safer because that looks pretty darn real steel, which I think is awesome, but only for certain situations. So this does make this blaster really, really cool because it can fit in pretty much any holster, including obviously the one it comes with, which I really like this product a lot. I've been running this on my hip around the house and just drawing it and getting a feel for the blaster for a while now. And that just locks in there really, really well. I mean, it fits perfectly. It's a very, very nice holster for a toy and has three settings on the holster there. So that's really, really cool. So let's go ahead and go over the features and how the blaster works real quick. You have two iron sights on top here. This actually is very effective and allows you to line up your shots and hit your target virtually every time. This is an extremely accurate blaster. So that is very useful and I really like them a lot. It is a top style prime blaster. So you will prime back to load your darts in, because there is a 6-dart internal magazine in there. You have some really cool feed lips there, and it is pretty easy to load in darts one by one. But obviously, as you saw, there's also a speed loader option, and you can stick that guy in there and load in darts really, really quickly. Those things work great, and I think it's a really cool add-on to this product, so that is pretty darn sweet. While this breech is open, there is a very interesting plunger tube in here. It is ovaled. It is maxing out the space of this blaster. Obviously, the back end of this pistol is a little longer than a real steel version of this. That is really the only significant difference from a, you know, a real steel pistol, in my opinion. But, you know, I think that's really cool and a great way to keep this blaster small. Basically, the plunger tube is also the pusher because the O-ring is right there. It just goes right into the breech and seals, and it doesn't have a great seal from what I can tell. But obviously it's delivering a lot of power, so very effective. We also have a safety right here. So this is, we push this to fire and this side for safe. So that's pretty cool. I really like the way where that is positioned. I think it's a perfect position for the safety. We'll go ahead and deprime it or fire it to deprime it. There we go. Another really cool feature is there are metal plates on the grip, which gives it a lot of weight in the hand, and I really like that a lot. I think that's a really nice touch. It makes it feel really, really nice, and just gives it a lot of weight there, which is a nice feature in my opinion. Like I said, we do have Picatinny here, sort of. It looks like it, but I don't think it will fit any attachments, unfortunately, which I do think is a little interesting why they went that way. But honestly, I don't plan on putting anything on there because I want to be able to holster this. This is the best part about this blaster, is it's so holsterable. And that is how I plan to run this, is probably not as a primary very much, unless I want to use it for a pistol round or something, or just for fun. But I do plan to use this all the time as my backup for HVZ, as long as short darts are allowed. And yes, this is a short dart only blaster, which is really cool that you can buy a short dart only blaster through Target. Well, at least Target.com. This is the future, guys. I mean, I don't know why, like I've said this before, I don't know why it's taken so long for these companies to figure this out, but Dart Zone has, and they're on the right track and they know it. So really, really cool that's happening, and I'm really excited to see what is to come, because if this is a short dart only blaster, then we could see so many more really cool things in the future. So, but that's what allows this to be so small and allows this to be possible, is because it's a half dart or short dart only blaster. So obviously being able to holster this blaster is one of the really, really cool things to me. The size of it and the amount of power you get from the size of blaster. I mean, really the only blasters that we have seen this size have been front loaders. I can't think of any internal magazine or anything that is this size that isn't a front loader, and most of those front loaders only shot one dart. The only real one that I can think of that shot more than one dart are like front loaders that are smart ARs, like the Messenger. There's a few that are, the Messenger could fit into this holster that I really like and use on my rig, but this is just for a real steel pistol and it fits in there perfect. So it's really easy to find alternative holsters that you can use with Molly or what have you. So that's really cool, and I'm glad that I can use this, because I cannot wear the holster that it comes with and my chest rig at the same time, because it just interferes with things and I have things hanging off of it like dump pouches and whatnot, and it just doesn't work, even though I really like the holster it comes with and I think it's really awesome. The speed loaders, guys, really, really cool. And I have heard now that you will be able to buy these separately at some point, which I think is awesome. I don't know if they'll come with additional holsters for them, or holders, or whatever you want to call them. But these are really cool and obviously work really well. You just have to lock it in there. It snaps in and you just push down. I mean, it feeds really quickly, really smooth, and I really like that a lot. Now, the grip, I would say, is fairly comfortable. I like it, but it isn't 100% perfect. It's not amazing. It's just okay. But for a pistol, I'm all right with that. It would have been nice to see them give me a little more shape, but I understand that they're limited because obviously there's a magazine going through here. So that's gonna affect things in terms of grip comfort and size. Obviously, you don't want to make it too bulky. So that probably played a role. This part right here, as some people have stated, kind of rubs on your thumb there a little bit. I haven't gotten a blister or anything from it, but yeah, if you're right-handed, that side, or if you're left-handed, the other side. And speaking of right and left-handed, obviously, this blaster is more friendly to right-handed players with the safety there, and then obviously the holster is definitely right-handed. I guess if you are left-handed, I thought about it, you could actually mount this on your back, which could be a really good place for it. That is one place I could actually run it and run my rig at the same time. But I don't really want to draw left-handed, obviously, off my back. That's not really going to work for me. But nevertheless, that is an option if you're left-handed. The only other slight complaint I have, and I actually bought two of these, so I think it's just my model, and I don't really know exactly what's going on there. I'll have to take a deeper dive when I actually open this blaster up. But inside here, there is something going on with my barrel. There's some scratches on it, and it just looks like the metal is super thin in two spots. But yeah, there's something weird going on in there, but it doesn't seem to affect performance. I have gone ahead and put this over the chronograph. I will roll some video for you guys of that. So I actually tested, obviously, the bamboo darts that come with the blaster, the Adventure Force Pro darts that are also made by Dart Zone, and then the Worker Gen 3s. Those seem to be the most popular in the hobby and most easily accessible for people. So just tried those three and had no issues with any of them. Obviously, there were some performance differences, but nothing super major. I got between 125 and 130 FPS average with all of them, so pretty close together there. The bamboos seem to be the most consistent dart. The workers actually seem to have the highest FPS, but also the lowest FPS, so they were the most inconsistent, which probably makes sense, given that they're probably they have the least quality control when making those darts. And then also the foam is thicker on the workers, so the barrel in the front here is quite wide in my opinion, and I think that's one place that we could look at to increase performance a bit, if there's a barrel option, and maybe even have to have a breech option too. I'm not sure yet, but the spring load is, I think, perfect. It's not easy to prime, but it's definitely not hard to prime. It is very nice, way easier than my modified M6 is, that's for sure. Probably even easier or on par with a modified Kronos, depending on what spring you go with there. But yeah, this is not bad at all. The pointy parts here on the prime are a little bit uncomfortable, depending on how you decide to grip them. But it is nice that you can prime it like that, and it gives you a nice grip there. But yeah, when you go like this, it kind of digs into your hand a little bit. So yeah, that's not amazing, but overall, I think it's a good grip, and I don't have too much of a problem with it. Getting back to the darts, I did have a slight issue on a couple of the Adventure Force Pro darts actually falling out of the barrel. It was so loose, and I just think those were some of the super thin ones. The Adventure Force Pro darts are a little bit thinner foam than other normal half-length darts, so they probably have more of a tendency to do that, but most of them didn't. I only had like one or two times where that actually happened to me, and I've used this quite a bit over the last like 5 days, so all in all, I'm very happy with the dart compatibility with this blaster. I think that that is really awesome, and I think that's probably one of the reasons why they go with a little wider barrel, so it works better with all types of darts, and that makes sense to me. Also put this thing over the range and got an average of between about 60 to 70 feet flat. I did get some worker darts to actually go closer to 100 feet, which were pretty amazing, but I also had some worker darts fall like really short. So very inconsistent with the worker darts. You might want to kind of sort through your worker darts and find the ones that are glued the best. I also haven't had great weather to test this thing outdoors, and it was kind of windy, so that could affect things also. But the majority of the bamboo darts and the Adventure Force Pro darts went between that 60 to 70 or so foot range, and I think that's really, really good for a small pistol like this. Very impressive. Now, I just want to say that this blaster looks awesome. The size of it obviously is really cool, and it looking real steel makes it good in a lot of ways, but this also could be a major issue. Please do not paint this blaster black or any sort of dark color. That would be really silly unless you plan on only using this indoors or in private fields. But honestly, bright colors are just better, you guys. It just is more fun. It's different, and that it's a toy. So let's make it look like one as much as possible. And that's why they included this part right here, obviously. And man, that looks really cool in my opinion. I may have to paint this thing up with this guy and probably try to remove this belt clip here. This is here, obviously, so you can keep this on your belt. And then when you pull your blaster out of the holster, you can go ahead and throw this on. So I think that's cool that they did that. Although I don't think I would practically ever do that. I mean, that just doesn't make sense to me unless I'm just doing it for fun. But if you're using this thing in an actual battle of any sort, that's going to be a wasted thing to do. So either I'm going to run it with this on completely, or I'm going to run it in a holster without this on. So that doesn't really make sense to me, but I do think that this could be useful in some ways in terms of modifying the blaster. If you want to lengthen the barrel, you could do it with this guy, and then you can maybe get some more performance out of the blaster. I thought it would be cool maybe even to have a kit or something. I'm sure Worker will probably come out with a kit. They just came out with a kit for the Nexus Pro, so maybe they'll come out for one with this. But having a barrel that is both short, have a short barrel and a long barrel so you can swap between the two, I think that would be really cool. So yeah, that would be pretty sweet, and it'd be cool if you could do it without opening the blaster. But Worker usually doesn't do things like that in terms of barrels, but someone else might, you know, something cool to do. Maybe you can just throw this on and it has the barrel in here and slides into maybe like an O-ring style breech similar to the Lynx. That'd be pretty sweet in my opinion. But there's lots of options. I can't wait to see what people do with this thing. But all in all, this thing is a ton of fun, and I highly recommend you thinking about purchasing one if you want a pistol or a sidearm in your loadout. I'll be honest, I wouldn't say it's something that you have to buy. If you're tight on budget, this is obviously $80 retail. I was able to pick it up slightly on sale. They had a 10% off coupon on Target when I bought this, and then I also have a red card, and that saves me another 5%. So definitely look out for sales. Target does have sales sometimes, especially around the holidays, so you may be able to score this thing a little bit cheaper. But it is a premium product, and they put a ton of time, obviously, into designing this thing, into creating a mold, and it's not something that's sold in stores, so I think that's why this line also has a little higher price tag, along with it being a little bit more premium than the Adventure Force Pro line. But $80 is still a lot. I think it could have, it would have been nice, obviously, to be a little cheaper, but that's probably the only real true negative I have about the product, is it being a little expensive. Same issue I kind of had with the original Mark 1 and obviously the Mark 1.1 there too. But I do think it's worth it, and I obviously picked up two of them, so I mean, I'm very happy with my purchase, and I cannot wait to crack this thing open and see if I can make it a little bit more consistent. I'm more worried about consistency, obviously, than increasing performance. But for HVZ, it's perfect right out of the box. For my wars, it'll be perfect just as it is. But it's always fun to tweak stuff. I know people think that this thing is maxed out in some ways, but I do think there's some things that we can do to increase performance. The seal is not 100%, which isn't a big thing, but I honestly don't feel like it has nearly as good a seal as other blasters that they've come out with, so maybe we can try to tweak that a little bit, I don't know, but yeah. Thank you guys so much for watching. I apologize for this being a little late. I did not receive this for free. I purchased this on my own, obviously, so that makes, obviously I have to wait for it to be shipped to me and everything like that, so I was a little later getting this than most reviewers. But Dart Zone, if you're watching, I'd gladly review all the products. If you want to shoot me those over, that'd be greatly appreciated. It would make it a little bit easier for me to do these videos and do them quicker. But I do like to, you know, use my blasters, especially ones like this, for a few days before I do a review, because I think it's important and gives you guys the best review I can give you. So thank you so much for watching. Make sure you smash that like button. Please subscribe, ring the bell for notifications, and as always, peace out.